all about covalent bonding.
Covalent bonding only involves non-metals. Non-metals are found on the right-hand side of the periodic table. My name is Mr. Barnes and I teach chemistry. Here we go.
All elements want a full outer shell. Non-metals want to gain electrons. Group 4,
gain 4 electrons.
Group 5,
gain 3 electrons.
Group 6, gain 2 electrons. You get the picture. Covalent bonding contains non-metals. Covalent bonding involves sharing new electrons. Shared pairs of electrons. Shared pairs of electrons.
Simple molecular substances involve a few atoms. Simple molecular substances have little melting points.
There are weak intermolecular forces.
Bond forces between molecules.
Not much energy is needed to overcome these forces.
Covalent
bonding contains non-metals. Covalent bonding involves sharing new electrons. Shared pairs of electrons.
Shy covalent substances involve lots of strong covalent bonds.
Giant covalent substances have high melting points.
Lots of energy is needed to break the strong covalent bonds.
They normally don't conduct electricity. The electrons are left free to move.
Covalent bonding contains non-metals.
Covalent bonding involves sharing new electrons. Shared pairs of electrons.
Diamond is an example. A giant covalent substance. Diamond is made up of carbon atoms, each bonded to four other carbons.
Diamond is used in cutting tools. Lots of energy is needed to break the strong covalent bonds.
Covalent
another giant covalent substance. Graphite is an allotrope of carbon.
And an allotrope is the same element in a different structure.
Graphite is used as electrodes.
Alkalized electrons are free to move.